Hello everyone, welcome to the Cisco FirePower Threat Defense course. In this training, we will discuss our topics through an example topology that you can often use in medium and large companies. Now, after briefly talking about the content of our training, let's start to process our topics gradually. In the first chapter, we will introduce the course. In the second chapter, we will first talk about the sample topology. Then we will do FMC and FTD installation, and in the fourth lesson we will talk about adding FTD to FMC. In our fifth lesson, we will make home lab example, and in our sixth lesson, we will make interface and zone settings. In our last lesson, we'll cover how to add static route. In the first lesson of the third chapter, we will log into access control policy. In our second lesson we will make an example of automatic NAT. In our third lesson we will set an example of manual NAT. And in our last lesson we will complete this chapter by making a destination NAT example. In Chapter 4, we will talk about next generation firewall features. I will tell you about topics such as SSL decryption, URL filtering, application filtering, malware, and file blocking, IPS inspection, security intelligence. We'll cover the authentication topic in Chapter 5. First we will make an introduction to passive authentication. Then we will activate the PX Grid service on Cisco IaaS so that we can run passive authentication. Then we will do Cisco IaaS integration into FMC. Then we will envy passive ID service on Cisco IaaS. After doing the Active Directory integration, we will create an identity policy in our last lesson. We will complete this chapter by creating a rule for passive authentication under this policy and performing our passive authentication tests. In the latest chapter, we'll cover device management topics. In our first lesson, we will cover how to add a remote FTD to FMC. In our second lesson, we will cover site-to-site VPN. And in our next lesson, we have a high availability lesson. After high availability, we will process the graphical user interface and SSH access settings. In our last lesson, we will complete our course by covering backup and restore topics. See you in the course.